Good morning, students. Today I am going to continue with the electromagnetism, right? So in the previous video I have already discussed the basic things regarding this magnetism and as well as the magnetic lines of force. Today I am going to discuss about the properties of the magnetic lines of force and later on the Worsted experiment, Ampere's screw law, all these things. Okay, so what is magnetic lines of force? It is basically the lines which is basically released from the north pole of the magnet and enters at the south pole of the magnet, right? Now the thing is that what are the properties which basically this lines of force follows? First thing is that two magnetic lines of force never intersect each other. Next is that basically there is no such magnetic lines of force. It is completely imaginary purpose. Third is that when I am telling about the magnetic lines of force, so the through per unit area, the number of lines of force that is released is known as the number density, right? And when two particular magnets are very close proximity to each other, their lines of force is not also collide with each other. Individually they exist. Okay, so these are the basic properties of the magnetic lines of force. Now coming to the Worsted experiment, what kind of experiment he has done? Let's see. Actually, he has taken a particular magnetic needle. And he just put a conducting wire at the above of this magnetic needle. Suppose if this is a magnetic needle, he just put a particular magnetic wire, conducting wire above this. Now, this is in the equilibrium position. No current is flowed through this conducting wire. Now, as he starts to flow the current, there is a current through this conducting wire, he had observed that magnet is being deflected like this. So it was this, it just deflected like this. Okay, so when he has observed that the deflection is occurring, when the current is stopped, the deflection becomes, or the magnet needle becomes original position. As the current is there, so there is a deflection, particular direction there is a deflection. Suppose this direction, in this direction. And when the direction of the current changes, then the side or deflecting side of the magnetic needle also changing, right? So by observing this, and as well as if he then put this wire under the magnetic needle, and he observed the same thing. That is, if a current is flowing, then there is a deflection. If the direction of the current changes, then also the direction of the deflection of the magnetic needle also changes, right? So after observing this, what kind of conclusion he has drawn? Basically, we all know that when I am telling about the magnet, a magnet can be interfered with another magnet, right? So if a particular magnetic field is there, then only if two magnetic field is there, then only we can observe this kind of attraction or repulsion, right? So when a magnet, through the conducting wire, when current is flowing, that means there is a deflection of the magnetic needle, right? That means whenever current is flowing, a particular magnetic field is generated. That's why that magnetic needle is being deflected, because magnetic needle itself has a particular magnetic field around it, right? When no current is there, there is no deflection on that magnetic needle. But as the current starts to flow, the magnetic field getting deflected. Why so? Because there should be, or there has to be, a particular magnetic field when, or there are particular magnetic field which is produced due to the flow of current, right? So therefore he has concluded that as when current is flowing, a magnetic field is being produced, and that's why the magnetic needle is being deflected, right? So, and when the direction is changing, that means magnetic lines of force is also changing. That's why the magnetic needle is being deflected. So, as when current is considered, and therefore a magnetic line is observed. So, therefore, basically, it is known as the electromagnetism. Why electromagnetism? The reason behind is that as electric current is flowing, and that's why the magnetic field is produced, so it is called the electromagnetism. Hopefully it is clear to all. Now, the thing is that this is basically the Oersted experiments and its his observations. Now, when the current is flowing, the magnetic needle is being deflected. Now, our concern is in which direction the magnetic needle is going to deflect, right? So, therefore, to answer this question, magnetic Ampere was there, and he had said a particular law which is known as the Ampere's swimming law, and he had said that if a particular person is swimming in the direction where the current is flowing, then while giving the stroke, the person's left hand side is going to a particular direction, so that direction is going to be the deflection of the magnet. So let's understand this statement pictorially. So if I consider that a particular man is swimming, this is the particular man who is swimming in the direction of the current flowing. So this is the direction of the current. In this direction, the person is swimming. So while swimming, it is giving strokes, and the direction at which his left hand is indicating, that will be the direction of the magnetic deflection. So that means if there is a magnetic needle, then the direction in this way, as the current is going in this way, so the deflection will be in this direction. If current flow is changing, that means his left hand side comes in this direction, so the deflection becomes in this way, right? So this is the basic thing for the Ampere's swimming rule. Okay. Sorry. Now, right hand thumb rule. According to this right hand thumb rule, if all the fingers of your right hand is directed indicating the direction of the current, then the left thumb is directed the magnetic field. So this is the basic thing, right? this is also known as the right thumb rule. Again, through the conductor, if I consider this is a conductor, if current is going in this direction, that is according to this thumb, if I just put this or grip this particular pen or conductor, and if my thumb is indicating the flow of the current, then the other fingers are going to indicate the magnetic field. If my I have just gripped this pen like this, if my thumb is in this direction, in the downward direction, that means the current is flowing in this direction, so the magnetic field will be in this direction. Okay, so this is the basic thing regarding these three laws. This is called that this particular law is called the Maxwell corkscrew rule. Okay, now coming to the circular magnetic lines of force. Suppose made a particular hole here, and through this current carrying conductor is flowing, and the current direction of the current is in this direction, right? So around this, the magnetic lines of force is going to be like this. So in this direction, this will be the north, and as it is a cardboard, so there will be a down portion that will be basically the south. Okay. So, and the direction of the magnetic field will be anti-clockwise. And if the current is flowing downward, then the direction of this magnetic lines of force will reversed. Okay. So this is the thing which I need to say you now. In the next video, I am going to start the power of word law. Thank you.